Okay, for those of you who are back home, here is the wife's niece of this activity. Having listened to colleagues, after having nabbed on all yourself, would you come up with one statement of intentionality? One thing you're committed to do, or one action step you're committed to take in the direction of creating this shared vision and shared understanding, okay? Each school, just one intentional step. As I said, you're going to come back to this. Well, we got here real quickly. One thing we're going to do, give you about a minute to decide on that, and then we'll have a roll call.
Use of conjunctions. It was just one sentence.
She packed a lot into it. Tracy, you have that pivot.
Basically, we were just really putting our emphasis in our teachers that are truly, truly invested in what's going on, and that their excitement and their enthusiasm just really trickle down.
Thank you. All right, Rod's finally your turn.
I'll go last.
No, you go next. I'm the decider.
What we want to do is we want to commit ourselves to be, and our staff, to be intentional as it relates to being the hope learners and having open doors as it relates to allowing others to come in to be able to see the fruits of the labor as it relates to them.
Lynn.
Well, our first step with all hands on deck will be for our administrators to meet, have a shared vision for student engagement so that our feedback to our teachers will be common.
And I happened to be listening into the high school when they were talking about that, and what I heard was not just meeting, but they want to go into classrooms, observe together, and be sure that they are in a position that whichever one of them went, the feedback would be consistent. Is that right? And that is huge, particularly in a large school with multiple administrators. And then hopefully what's going to happen, as I heard so many of you say, is over the course of the year, every teacher is going to come to share that understanding and thereby, you know how to kind of close that gap between what I'm doing and what I'd really like to be doing. Well, this is a first step in your forming that plan for your school that I hope when you leave tomorrow afternoon, you'll be on fire about. We're going to leave it for a little while because after you come back from break, you've been talking about practice, we're going to be looking at documents. And when we come back to look at those documents, I'm going to ask Dr. Womack that she can kind of lead in as to the why of what we're going to do. And we'll probably spend the rest of the morning on that task. So just a heads up, you will need to have access to, I guess this needs to happen here, right? You'll need to have access to your strategic plan and your instructional roadmap, either on the screen or in hard copy, because you'll be looking to those as we do this next work. And I've got 10:15 on my watch. I don't know about yours, but I'm going to put 10 minutes on the timer and invite you to take a break and try to be back 10 minutes from now, ready to roll up the sleeves and work some more. Yes, ma'am. You want the final word from now. Yes. That's okay.
I do want to take models of best practice is if we could, when you identify the implementation that has arrived and has become where you want it to be in your building, that we should share those things. Really, it shouldn't be just Mayor Baker Chris going into the building. It should be you all sharing those videos and district-wide we again become more intentional about this is what that looks like and that vision can be more shared.
You know, I'm glad you said that, Myra. I'm glad you said that because videotaping was mentioned in two contexts. And I hope you will really think about how to use the videotaping in these two contexts. In the context of building this library, which will be a wonderful resource for your district that will be public. But I don't want to overlook what Amy said. The most powerful learning a teacher can do is to see themselves or their students. I always say teachers don't want to see their face on the video. Focus the camera on the kids, because what we care about is what are the students doing. Sure. You know, not what to see that, it's for my eyes only. I reflect. I use some kind of rubric, as Amy was saying, to see where I am and where I want to go. And maybe I ultimately get comfortable enough that I want to invite my coach in to view it with me so we can talk about it together. Maybe I want to keep it, whatever, but that reflection is so powerful. That opportunity to see an exemplar in my own district is also powerful. But kind of serve similar purposes, but they're real different uses of the technology. So keep those in mind. I didn't start the 10 minutes yet, so I'll just start it right now. Okay, thank you. And remember, y'all, they have those dots.
Mr. Chairman, please.